In lesson 5.7, as a demonstration, you can add food coloring to water and show that a liquid can dissolve in a liquid. Most students think about a solid dissolving in liquid, but liquids can dissolve in liquids. Then, students will take a look at alcohol, that's isopropyl alcohol, corn syrup, and oil being mixed in water. And the question they investigate is, do alcohol, corn syrup, and oil dissolve in water differently? And eventually, why is that? And the big science concepts covered are that a liquid can dissolve in another liquid. In this case, we try to dissolve all the liquids in water. Whether a liquid dissolves in water or not depends on the interaction of the molecules of the liquid with the water molecules. Students will see that liquids that are polar dissolve better in water than liquids that are nonpolar. So let's take a look at alcohol being placed in water. This is isopropyl alcohol, which means it's 70% isopropyl alcohol. And you see the kind of swirling action that you see when alcohol mixes with water. And if you give it a little swirl with a straw, it mixes pretty well. Students will see that it mixes in. At this point, students know that water is a polar molecule. They've also seen that alcohol is only slightly polar. We explain to students that that amount of polarity is enough to have the alcohol mix in with the water and dissolve. Students also put corn syrup in water. That's basically sugars, and we mix that with a straw. Originally, it just sinks to the bottom and doesn't seem to dissolve, but that's really because it's pretty dense. Sugar is a pretty big, heavy molecule, and it falls to the bottom, but if you swirl it around with a straw, it will dissolve. And that should make sense to students based on what they know about the water molecule and the sucrose molecule, which has a lot of areas of polarity on it. Then students put some oil, in this case we use a little vegetable oil. Instead of sinking to the bottom the way the corn syrup did, in this case it floats to the top because it's less dense. No matter how much you stir it, it won't mix in with the water. It doesn't dissolve. If you take a look at it, it's pretty nonpolar. These carbon-hydrogen bonds are only very, very slightly polar, so this is basically considered a nonpolar molecule. So on the student activity sheet, students are given an opportunity to explain their observations in terms of polarity for each of the different molecules that was mixed in with the water. If you're in an NGSS state, there's a performance expectation, MSPS11, which says, develop models to describe the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures. Lesson 5.7 relates to this performance expectation mainly because students look at the molecules alcohol, sucrose, and oil to understand why they dissolve when interacting with water molecules. If you look at the foundation boxes, for science and engineering practices, develop a model to predict or describe phenomena. Well, students do that. The phenomena they see is the way the different liquids dissolve in water. They can describe that phenomena based on the molecules that interact with the water molecules. They also carry out a very simple investigation by placing the different liquids in water and stirring them in the same way. For disciplinary core ideas, this idea that substances are made from different types of atoms, which combine with one another in various ways, students see that the three different substances that they used all are made of different molecules, and that results in them having different polarities, which results in them having different characteristics. Each pure substance has characteristic physical and chemical properties, in this case, the physical property of dissolving or not dissolving. And for scale, proportion, and quantity, the idea that students analyze a substance all the way down to the molecular level to describe or to help understand a macroscopic observation that they make of whether the substance dissolves or doesn't dissolve in water. So thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.